Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video series deals with working on various CGI render passes in Autodesk Smoke. The project is now created. The media and render passes are imported into Smoke, and we can start thinking about compositing. One very big aspect to consider is how the colors of the CGI render passes will be blended with the colors of the video background. This is what we'll focus on for this video. There are two choices you can make when dealing with the color in your images. The first choice is to combine the CGI with the video straight away and hope that all the colors match up. However, more than likely, the colors will be wrong. You could use color corrections and tweak the image, but it will never be 100% correct. If you are looking for a true representation of color and light to create photorealism, this is not the best choice. The second choice is to tell Smoke how to represent and accurately display the colors. By doing this, you keep the colors consistent through your production pipeline when going from 3D to compositing. This is the preferred way of working when combining CGI with live action. In order to composite the background with the rendered CGI passes correctly, you need to understand the color space and image state of the colors in each element. There are two color components I want to highlight: bit depth and color space. Bit depth refers to the amount of color information stored in your image. ConnectFX in Smoke is designed to work natively at 16-bit floating point, but it can load 8-bit sources if desired. By working at 16-bit floating point, the ConnectFX toolset has greater accuracy and finite control over the various effects processes. Therefore, media sources imported into ConnectFX should be promoted into 16-bit floating point. For example, we already have the background video imported into ConnectFX. You can see in the notes description that it was promoted from 10-bit to 16-bit color depth. The original image quality won't improve, but it does mean that Smoke will apply 16-bit float point precision processes to the data to maximize the image quality during compositing. Go to your Shot 1 folder and drag in any of the render passes into the ConnectFX schematic. You will note that they already contain a 16-bit color depth. These OpenExrs were rendered in Autodesk Maya at 16-bit float point, so they don't need to be promoted in ConnectFX. So there is an amazing amount of color information to work with in these images. The second and more complex component to discuss is color space. This refers to how color is mapped inside your image's file. By having this knowledge, you can ensure color consistency in the compositing pipeline. So when it comes to 3D applications, CGI is typically rendered using a linear workflow. This means that the color values directly represent the virtual light energy in the 3D scene. If you add twice as much light into your scene, the scene will be twice as bright based on the luminance values. So the output of the CGI render is naturally linear, because this represents how light naturally reacts in the real world. Please be aware that this all comes down to graphics rendering mathematics. We call this color space scene linear for these reasons. Now, CGI render passes are stored as OpenExr files. This is because this format can support the colors in a linear floating point encoding. This is one of many reasons why OpenExr is considered an industry standard format. However, when it comes to our eyes and our viewing devices, we see things very differently. The bottom line is that our eyes perceive light in a non-linear way. Our eyes see more detail in darker areas than in bright areas. So in order for us to see the images correctly, we need to bend the linear colors by doing tone remapping as well as a gamma correction on the luminance values. This allows us to see the images correctly as our eyes expect. So a lot of the popular image formats store colors in a nonlinear corrected color space for convenience sake. This also has a carryover effect to all of our viewing devices in two ways. Firstly, monitors, tablets, and smartphones are inherently designed with a built-in form of nonlinear compensation to accurately display the imagery. Secondly, a real-world scene can have a very large range of light energy, from very dark to very bright. The brightest objects can be many times brighter than the maximum of 1.0 that can be displayed on a monitor or projector. So let's call this color space video, as it typically represents what we see on a monitor. In the case of our video background, the digital camera sensor recorded the image in linear values. But to save the images, the camera must tone map the image to squeeze the high dynamic range of the real world into the 0 to 1 range of a monitor. Then it must apply a gamma for the video encoding. This means it looks correct when we play it back straight away on a monitor. However, you must always remember that the video colors do not represent the original light energy in the scene. Cameras like RED capture raw data. In post-production, you can then choose what color space you would like the material to be displayed at. So returning to our example, the challenge is how to combine the nonlinear live action with the linear CGI. We have different elements that need to be combined together, but their colors are stored differently to each other. The most elegant solution is to transform all the colors into a single color space. With all the colors sitting in the same color space, hopefully compositing should go smoothly. Therefore, in Smoke, we need to remap the colors of the video background to match the CGI colors. Hover over the ConnectFX node bin and press L for the LUT editor. Drag the LUT editor node out of the node bin and connect it after the video background. Double-click on the LUT editor node to bring up its menus. Change the conversion pull-down menu from Gamma to Color Transform. Click Import to enter into the file browser. Here you have a selection of color transformations to remap your image. Go into the Tone Map folder and choose the Inverse Photo Map option. Coming back to ConnectFX, you will see the input and output descriptions. We are transforming, or what we call inverting, the tone mapping of the color space of this clip from generic video values with a gamma correction to generic scene linear values. Historically, some people just use a gamma transform for this purpose. But that is not correct, since video cameras apply tone mapping in addition to gamma correction, and both should be inverted. However, if your CGI render passes were lit using the older workflow and do not have values above 1.0, then you may want to use one of the transforms from the gamma directory, such as remove rec709encoding.ctf. So the color space of the background now matches the CGI render passes. But just like the render passes, all the colors now appear incorrect. This is because monitors were never designed to show a scene linear color space. Smoke's viewers are set to display video that displays a nonlinear corrected color space. So only for viewing purposes, we need to temporarily remap the Smoke viewer with a color transformation. This will show the images correctly in our monitors, but we still work accurately in a scene linear color space. To load a color transform for the viewer, we need to go to the Preferences menu. Press Command Comma, and this will bring up the preferences. Switch to the LUT tab and choose the 3D LUT and Color Transform option. Press Import. In the browser, ensure the pull-down menu is set to the Autodesk Color Transforms and not the Project Transforms. Otherwise, you won't see anything. Go to the same Tone Map folder and you will find the two tone mapping color transformations. The PhotoMap Gamma 2.4 color transformation will work fine for this example. This transformation assumes the gamma of the monitor is 2.4. This is quite generic for most broadcast monitors. However, if your monitor is different than the regular standard display, then you will need to know what gamma shift to apply. Then, you can make your own color transform using the photo map tool inside the LUT editor. Select the photo map color transform and you will see it assigned in the list. If you applied one of the inverse gamma transforms to your video footage rather than the inverse photo map, you would load a simple gamma transform here. For example, apply a 2.2 gamma or apply sRGB encoding to match your monitor. Close the Preferences menu. In the Result Viewer, you can now switch the viewer mode from video to linear photo map. The background should now look correct as previously, but its color information is now in scene linear color space. If you select the render pass, it will also be displayed in the viewer with the linear photo map color transform and it will look correct. So in summary, we have all our media in a common color space. This will allow them to composite correctly and ensures mathematical accuracy. And finally, we had to enable a color transformation on the viewers to apply the nonlinear correction to our display. This ensures our eyes will see the colors correctly. In the next video, we will start compositing a few passes together to build up the composite. Thank you for watching and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.